Hello, I'm Brittany Sweeney here to introduce you to our artist of the month. This ninth grader does amazing artwork using herself as the canvas. Here now as the artist of the month for March is Morgan Letito. Great to have you, Morgan.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations on becoming the artist of the month. Tell us about yourself.
I have always been very artistic, and growing up through the years, I've seen things on the internet of people using themselves as canvases and doing makeup on themselves. And it's interested me so much that I decided to pick up some makeup brushes myself and combine my artistic talent and create looks on myself.
Wonderful. So you're a makeup artist, you're a painter, and you use yourself as a canvas. All right, let's introduce your parents here. We have Kelly and Michael, and they're gonna come in. They are very proud of you. They're gonna tell us a little bit about how they knew that you were an artist. Great to have you both.
Thank you.
Great to be here, thank you.
Kelly, why don't you talk to us first about your daughter? When did you know that she was an artist?
Well, ever since Morgan was very little, probably about 3 years old, she's always been very artsy. Even in preschool, she would pick up a scissors and just randomly cut things into shapes and stuff and really enjoyed it. And that moved into pretty much any other kind of art that you can think of, from pencils to markers to painting, clay, you name it, she's done it. And now she's found that painting on her face is what she really likes to do the most.
So she's just a creative person
yes.
all around.
Yes.
And Michael, the first time you realized your daughter was an artist, you got quite the surprise.
I did. One of the first transformations I saw, I came home and she had this black wig, sideburns, a mustache. I mean, she looked like, she called herself Carlos. And I tell you, I couldn't believe the transformation. She looked like a young man and my beautiful daughter. And I was like, what happened?
Where'd my daughter go, right? But she's that talented. You thought
yes.
it was a completely other person.
Unbelievable. Right down to her clothes, everything. It was
wow.
crazy.
Well, without further ado, let's take a look at some of your artwork, starting with a picture that when I first saw it, I thought it was a digital picture, but this is actually some makeup that you did yourself. So talk to me about this picture here.
So I created this picture and it took about 4 hours to do the makeup for
wow.
it. And I used reference photos, looked at pictures of actual muscle anatomy, and tried to recreate it to the best of my abilities on myself.
Wow, that is absolutely fabulous. Now, do you use regular makeup for this, or is this more of a face paint?
This is more of a face paint and eyeshadows and things like that.
That's amazing. Kelly, talk to us about this. When you saw this, what did you think?
I was amazed. Just the intricacy of it was amazing.
Absolutely, yeah. The detail is absolutely amazing.
Thank you.
All right, now we're gonna take a look at how you do this. You made a time-lapse video to show us some of the makeup. Let's talk about that video. What are you doing here for this makeup?
Right now, I'm doing my base makeup and my eyebrows. And for this look, I wanted to really show off that I could do a lot of things with color. So I chose to do a very colorful eyeshadow look, which I'm starting here. And then later on, it felt very flat to me, so I wanted to add some texture. So I took some hot glue dots that I made and I put them on my face and I colored them white so that there was it was more visually appealing and there was more things to look at.
Great, we're gonna look at that finished product, which is absolutely amazing. Where do you get the inspiration for things like this?
I follow many Instagram accounts that all are amazing at makeup, and YouTube videos are really what taught me to do makeup. So all of those different creators out there are what inspire me.
Awesome, and you don't just do this on yourself. We have a pretty neat picture of Dad here
yeah.
with some of the artwork you've created on him. Talk to us about that picture.
So he had a Halloween party to go to, so he wanted to look like the Terminator. So I got up early and I told him to lay down on the bed. He fell asleep while I was doing it.
True.
And I did everything and put the Terminators on his face, and then he went off to his party.
That looks so cool. And what were the reactions from the people at the party?
People couldn't believe it. They really thought that, what happened to your face? I got that a lot. And then they looked at it. I mean, they knew right away it was the Terminator.
That is so cool. Like I said, this is just truly amazing. Where do you hope to go from here? What are some of the other things you'd like to try?
I'm always interested in learning new forms of artwork and expanding my talents and just growing and growing and to be the best that I can be.
Wonderful. And what does it mean to you to be the artist of the month for March?
It makes me very excited and very proud, and I thank you for this opportunity so much. It's amazing, and I'm very excited for people to see what I can do.
Wonderful. We're excited to follow you and see some of the artwork that is to come. Thank you so much for joining us. Morgan, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Thank you all so much for being here. And PBS 39 is looking for students in grades K through 12 to submit their masterpieces for a chance to become one of our featured artists of the month for 2020. Go to pbs39.org to find out how to apply, and remember to keep creating. For PBS 39, I'm Brittany Sweeney.